In this video, we start with a quick reminder of the definitions of the hyperbolic sine function, or sinh, and the hyperbolic cosine function, or cosh. So there's the definitions of these functions. And then we want to figure out what are the derivatives of these things. And so if I look at the derivative of sinh, the 1/2 is a spectator. And then I have the derivative of e to the x, which is just e to the x. And then I have in my second term the derivative of e to the negative x. That requires the chain rule. So you differentiate with respect to negative x, and you get e to the negative x. And then you have to multiply by the derivative of negative x with respect to x. That tacks on an extra factor of -1. And when I clean things up, I see that the second term becomes positive, and I recognize this as the cosh function. So the derivative of sinh is cosh. You might see what's coming next. Differentiate cosh with respect to x. The derivative does nothing to the e to the x part, but the e to the negative x part, again, a minus sign drops out of that because of the chain rule. So I have the derivative with respect to negative x multiplied by the derivative of negative x. Clean things up, and it turns out the derivative of cosh is sinh. So these have a little simpler derivative behavior than sine and cosine. They just, each time you differentiate one of them, you get the other one. In the next example, we want to compute the first derivative of sinh of 3x. So it's just a little chain rule problem. And to get this, I would differentiate with respect to 3x, which gives me cosh 3x, treating 3x like it's just a single variable. And then the chain rule says, now you got to multiply by the derivative of 3x with respect to x. So I get a factor of 3 out of that. And now I have 3 cosh 3x. The third example might introduce a concept you've never seen before. I'm talking about a differential equation here. But in my opinion, the earlier the better. So I'm saying for f of x equals cosh x, compute the second derivative, and then show that this function f of x satisfies this equation. That if you differentiate it twice, you get back the original function you started with. That's actually a second order differential equation. And any function that satisfies that rule, that you differentiate it twice and you get back what you started with, that's a solution to a second order differential equation. So let's get the first derivative of f. That gives me sinh. Get the next derivative. The derivative of sinh is cosh. And I'm back where I started. And so if you want to write a clean sort of proof that this satisfies the differential equation, you would say f double prime of x is equal to cosh x, but that's equal to the original function f of x. And we've shown the second derivative is equal to the original function. Therefore, cosh x satisfies the second order differential equation. If you find the math content on Zach's Lab helpful, click on the Zach's Lab logo on the right to browse playlists and subscribe to the channel. I produce dozens of new videos per month, and subscribing is the easiest way to find new content. Thanks for watching.